paano nga ba ang tamang paggamit ng verbs na come and go? Yan ang ituturo ko sa inyo sa video na ito. How's it going? My name is Myra Kagete, your Pinay English teacher here on YouTube, and welcome to a new English tutorial video. Katulad ng sinabi ko kanina, sa video na ito ay ituturo ko sa inyo kung paano ang tamang paggamit ng verbs na come and go. The use of come depends on the current position of the speaker and the listener in the conversation. We use the verb come when we talk about the direction toward the speaker or toward the listener. Okay, ano ba ang ibig sabihin ng speaker at listener sa isang conversation? Halimbawa, tayong dalawa yung nag-uusap. Pagkatapos, ako yung nagsasalita or ako yung nagbibigay ng mensahe, ibig sabihin, ako yung speaker sa ating conversation. At ikaw naman yung listener because of course, ikaw yung nakikinig o kaya naman ikaw yung tumatanggap ng mensahe. Kung ikaw naman yung nagsasalita, then of course, ikaw yung speaker at ako naman yung listener kasi ako yung nakikinig or ako yung tumatanggap ng mensahe mo. We use the verb come when we are talking about movement toward the speaker or the listener. Halimbawa, nasa office ka, pagkatapos tinawagan kita at sinabi ko sa iyo na pupunta ako sa opisina mo ng alauna ng hapon. I can say, I will come to your office at 1 p.m. So I'm talking about movement toward the listener kasi ikaw nga yung tinawagan ko. So ako rin yung nagsabi sa iyo na I will come to your office at 1 p.m. I used come in my sentence because there's movement toward the listener. Another example, nag-uusap tayong dalawa, pagkatapos gusto kong pumunta ka sa opisina ko naman ng alauna ng hapon, then I can say, can you please come to my office at 1 p.m.? There's movement toward the speaker in the conversation. From your position to my position or location. I'll give you another situation. So, halimbawa, boss mo ako, tapos nasa office na ako, nasa trabaho na ako, and you called in sick. So, tumawag ka dahil gusto mong sabihin na may sakit ka nga at hindi ka makakapasok sa trabaho. In that situation, you can say, I can't come to work. I'm terribly sick. So, I used the verb come because we're talking about movement toward the listener in the conversation. Kung ako naman yung magsasalita sa conversation natin, then I can say, you don't need to come to work if you're sick. So, when we make plans, we can also use the verb come to talk about the direction toward our future position. For example, it's my birthday next week and I'm throwing a party and I want to invite you to my birthday party. I can say, will you come to my party? In that situation, I'm talking about movement to my future position. Sa sitwasyon na yan, ako yung speaker, kasi ako yung nagsalita, ako yung nagbigay ng message or nagtanong sa'yo. Kung ikaw naman yung speaker sa ating conversation, then you can respond with, sure, I can come to your party. Or, I'm sorry, I can't come to your party. We can also use the verb come when we are talking about movement from another position toward the position of the speaker and the listener. So, sa sitwasyon na to, ang pinag-usapan naman natin ay yung movement nga or direction from another place, okay, mula sa ibang lugar, papunta sa location or kung nasaan ang speaker at ang listener. They will come here tomorrow. So we're talking about movement from one place to the position of the speaker. Kasi ako yung nagsalita, so of course I'm talking about movement from one place to my position. My best friend is coming to see me tomorrow. The police officer is coming toward us. We usually use the verb go when we talk about movement from the position of the speaker or the listener to another place. Go ang gagamitin natin kapag ang pinag-uusapan natin ay movement or direction from our location. Kasi tayo nag-uusap. Halimbawa, magkasama tayo sa bahay. Pagkatapos, tatanungin kita kung pupunta ka ba sa trabaho, kung pupunta ka ba sa opisina mo. Then I can say, are you going to your office today? Halimbawa, hindi maganda yung pakiramdam mo, kaya you wanna tell me na hindi ka papasok sa trabaho. Then in that case, you can say, I'm not going to the office today. Kasi nga, we're talking about movement from our position to another location. Another example, we are both invited to another friend's birthday party, and I wanna ask you if you're attending. So I can say, are you going to her birthday party? Papunta sa birthday niya. And then you can respond by saying, yes, I'm going to her birthday party, or no, I can't go to her birthday party. So again, sa sentences na yan, ginamit natin yung go kasi we're talking about movement from our position or from the position of the speaker or the listener to another location or to another position. Now let's do an activity. Situation number one. We are on the phone and I'd like to ask if you will attend my wedding. Which of the following is the appropriate question to ask? Letter A, are you coming to my wedding? Letter B, are you going to my wedding? The correct answer is letter A. Are you coming to my wedding? We are talking about movement toward the future position of the speaker. Situation number two. We live in the same house. It's already midnight and you're still outside with your friends. I call you and ask, letter A, what time will you come home? Letter B, what time will you go home? The correct answer is letter A. What time will you come home? I'm talking about movement toward me, the speaker. Situation number three. We're both here in the Philippines, and I want to ask you about visiting Japan. Which of the following is the correct question to ask? Letter A. When will you come to Japan? Letter B. When will you go to Japan? The correct answer is letter B. When will you go to Japan? We are talking about movement from the position of the speaker or the listener to another place. Situation number four. You work abroad. We're talking on the phone and you want to tell me that you're finally returning to our country. Which of the following is the correct sentence to say? Letter A. I'm coming home. Letter B. I'm going home. The correct answer is letter A, I'm coming home. We are talking about movement toward the listener. Situation number five. You are an OFW and your contract has ended. You say goodbye to your boss because you're finally returning to your country. Which of the following is the correct sentence to say? Letter A, I'm coming home. Letter B, I'm going home. The correct answer is letter B. I'm going home. We're talking about movement from the position of the speaker or the listener to another place. Please don't forget to like and share this video with your friends. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet. And thank you so much for your time today. I'll just see you again next time.